Well, welcome back to American Agenda. I'm Heather Childers along with Bob Sellers. In collaboration with two other senators, our next guest sent a letter to Health and Human Services Secretary Xavier Becerra demanding transparency on the resettlement of unaccompanied alien children across the United States. In a news release, these lawmakers said the following. Rather than securing the border, it appears that the Biden administration's strategy for addressing the border crisis is to take as many steps as possible to simply accelerate processing of migrants into the interior of the United States. And policies adopted by the Biden administration have become the root cause for the collapse of our southern border and the influx of record numbers of illegal crossers and the flow of illicit and deadly drugs. Joining us now to discuss is Tennessee Senator Marsha Blackburn. Senator, thank you so much for joining us. It's great to have you here in person.
And it is wonderful to be here with you all. Yeah. And thanks for bringing attention to this issue. Everyone's concerned about this because the way the Biden administration is handling these migrants and the illegal immigration, it is making every state a border state, every town a border town.
Well, it seems like what the Biden administration is doing is, for instance, in your state, he's flying these kids to Chattanooga. Right. Now, from Chattanooga, they can stay in Tennessee, they can go to Georgia, they can go to Alabama, they can go to North Carolina. Well, why are they doing that?
They are doing this so that they're transferring the cost of education, health care, housing, child services, social services. They're transferring that to your local and state governments. And see, these individuals that have been coming across the border illegally, they are traumatized individuals. They've been physically and sexually abused by the cartels. These individuals, I think if you gave them a choice, they would say, send me home to my family, because of what they've lived through with the cartels. You cannot cross that southern border unless you're going through a cartel.
What is the answer, though? What's the solution? Because I know I have heard of some states, specifically the governor of South Carolina is one of them, who are saying, no, you can't bring these children into our state. Is that the only option for governors to stand up?
You know, what is so interesting, Heather, Tennessee's governor, Governor Lee, declined the request of the federal government to bring those migrant children in. So they're doing it anyway. So our legislation says, look, if you're going to do this, you better notify the state and the local government because you're shifting this burden to them. And these are individuals that have been abused physically, emotionally, sexually abused, and they're in need of a high level of service. Now, the thing to do is to put President Trump's Remain in Mexico policy back in place. That way, individuals seeking asylum stay in a safe third country until their asylum claim is heard. And right now, we know that people from 160 different countries are included in the 500,000 illegal aliens that have been caught and released into the country this year.
Wow.
During his rally on Saturday, former President Trump had some things to say about Kamala Harris, about her trip to the border. Let's take a look at that for a moment.
Kamala Harris, your vice president, only went to the border yesterday for the one simple reason, because I announced that I was going next week, and I am, at the request of Texas Governor Abbott and the Border Patrol. I'm going to the border next week. Oh, if I didn't do that, I don't know if she was ever going to go. I really don't know if that was she ever going to go. I don't know.
Your thoughts?
President Trump did step out and say he would do this town hall with Governor Abbott. And yes, indeed, I think this forced Vice President Harris to have to go to the border. Now, interestingly enough, she went to El Paso, where they have the border wall up and where the crossings are down. She did not go to the Rio Grande sector, where you have the crossings up and you have more than double the amount of people that are coming in at El Paso. So it just shows you, she's saying things are getting better. Well, you look at the border wall you've got there. Walls work. Right. They absolutely work.
Right. Going back to the migrant children being taken into other states all across this country, They don't have to show that they're related to anyone, because I remember initially one of the things that the Biden administration was talking about doing is DNA testing at the border to see if these children were in fact related to people that they were being taken with.
The Trump administration had a pilot project That would have required the DNA testing, and they did that, and they found that 20% of the children were not related to the adult that was bringing them. So I put that into legislative form to make that federal law. We should do that to protect these children, because there is a program that the cartels are carrying out. It's called child recycling.
Yes.
Now, how barbaric is that? And these precious children are being used to help an adult get across the border. Their name and address is written on their arm with indelible ink, and then they are sent back across the border. This is a horrific existence. Mm-hmm. So you have to get this border under control. And you know what is so interesting to me? The Biden administration continues to ignore the problem, but now all the polling shows the American public, by a vast majority, feels like this is an issue that has to be addressed.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Can you stand? Stay with us a second. We'll take a break, come back. There's more to talk about after the break with the senator. Stay with us.